Hey everyone, this is the first video in a series covering Microsoft Excel tips and tools that every engineer should know. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to create a histogram in Excel 2016. I'll talk about why histograms are useful and some applications for them. So here we have a bunch of data, and this data is actually a bunch of measurements taken from different production runs of this particular shaft. And we're looking at this diameter. So we've taken a bunch of measurements throughout the runs to understand what the variation is on that shaft diameter. And if we wanted to understand this, we could take an average and look at all the data points and say, all right, well, that's our average. And let's say we had a 2/1000ths of an inch tolerance on the shaft diameter. We'd say, all right, on average, we're within tolerance. And some people might look at that and say, okay, that's just fine. But if we really wanted to understand how well we're doing at actually achieving this diameter, then we'd have to make a histogram. Now, Excel 2016 has made it really easy to do this. We just have to go to the Insert tab, select our data, go back up to the top here, and then there's these new statistical charts as of 2016 that includes a histogram. And there we go. There is our histogram, which is essentially a frequency distribution of the data. So it's telling us how many samples are within these different bin ranges. So it defaulted to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bins, and between 0.9937 and 0.9953, it looks like there was seven measurements in that bin. Now, I'm not exactly sure how Excel calculates the number of bins or the bin ranges, but we are able to go in here and manually set up our bin ranges. It sets to automatic by default. We can use a bin width or a number of bins. And that's kind of interesting. If we change it to 7 bins, even though it had 7 bins before, it changes the way the histogram looks. So just kind of be aware of that. Just in general, the number of bins is going to change the way the distribution looks. So if I jump this up to 10, we can see that's what our distribution looks like. The equation I usually use to select the number of bins is this. So K is your number of bins, and then you take the square root of the count of data samples. And in my case, I have 100 samples, so if I took the square root of 100, that'd be 10. So I would actually use 10 for my bin number. Now, this is a good rule of thumb, so this will work just fine for our case.
So now, if we look at this and ask the question, how are we doing at actually achieving this 1-inch diameter? And remember, we said we had a 2/1000ths of an inch tolerance, so if we keep that in mind, we can see that it actually looks like there's one value here that's above that tolerance, or outside of that range. And then here we actually have, well, 17 plus 7 that are for sure outside, and maybe even a few more here.
So even though on average the data is within the tolerance range, because of variation, the data actually is distributed, and that makes some of the data outside of the tolerance range. So let's take a look at another example of how we can use a histogram. Now we're going to take a look at how many shafts we're completing per shift. So if we grab our data and go to the Insert tab and make another histogram, we can see that now it actually defaulted to 5 bins. Again, I don't know how Excel is calculating the bin number. I'll have to do some more digging on that. But let's bump up the number of bins and see what the distribution looks like. We'll use the square root of n method again. And we can see that we actually have a bimodal distribution, meaning that there's two modes or most common values in our histogram. So we might ask the question, well, why is that? It could be that there's two different operators or two different shifts that are producing different amounts of shafts per shift. So this is a really good example, again, of why things like an average don't give you the whole picture, because our average is actually right here. But most of the values are either higher or lower than that. Let's take a look at one last example. So here we have some job data, and we're going to compare the due date of the job to the completion date of the job to see how well we're doing at hitting our due dates. So if we want to look at that, we'll grab our column where we're looking at the difference of the due date and completion date. So here's a histogram of that, and we can see that it has kind of this right skew. Let's actually change the bins so they give us a better idea of what's going on. Let's use the bin width in this case, and let's set it to 1 just because we're talking in terms of days. So here's the distribution. Again, we can see that it has this right skew where it looks like most of the time we're hitting the due date, but it kind of tails off, and then there's some jobs that are being completed way after the due date. So rather than just kind of asking the question, why are we always late, or why are our customers always mad at us, we can begin to understand
how often we're late, and to what degree are we late, just by looking at this visual diagram of the frequency distribution of the difference between due dates.
So hopefully these three examples have given you an idea of how to use histograms, why they can be useful, and how to create one for yourself. Let me know in the comments below how you use histograms in your business. I'd love to hear about some other applications. And if you're new to using histograms, let me know how you plan to incorporate them into your engineering toolbox. Thanks for watching. All right, I hope you all enjoyed that one. To get more videos as they are released, make sure to hit that subscribe button. If you like this video, make sure to like and share. And if you didn't like it, well, then leave me a comment and let me know how I can improve. Last but not least, this channel is for you, so if you have any suggestions for topics you want me to cover, make sure to let me know. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.